Our today lecture is based on chromatography and its types. My name is Dr. Alam Zeb. I am a professor at the Department of Biochemistry, University of Malacca. Classification or the types of chromatography are based on two type classification schemes. The first one is data base, which is based on mobile base. The second type of classification is based on attractive forces. Now the first class, the first type of classification is which is based on mobile base. In this case, we have three main classes of chromatography. The first one is gas chromatography, in which the mobile piece is a gas. Normally, it's a different type of gases. And the second one is liquid chromatography, in which the mobile piece is usually liquid, different type of liquids. And the third one is the supercritical fluid chromatography, in which the mobile piece is the supercritical fluid. The second type of classification, which is based on attractive forces, this include four main type of chromatography. The first one is absorption chromatography, in which the mechanism of separation is based on absorption. And the second one is called ion exchange chromatography, in which the separation is based on the ion exchange principles. The third one is the partition chromatography, in which the separation is based upon the partition between the two phases. And the fourth one is size exclusion chromatography, in which separation is based on sizes of the molecule. Now the first class among the second classification is absorption chromatography. In this case, the separation is based on their adsorption onto the surface of solid, which is usually stationary phase. The mixture of gas or liquid gets separated when it passes over the adsorbent beds that absorbs different compounds at different rates. Some commonly used absorbent for absorption chromatography are silica gel H, silica gel G, silica gel N, silica gel S, hydrated gel silica, cellulose, microcrystalline, alumina, modified silica gel, etc. And now you can see here the most common example is the Karam chromatography, in which the first case the sample is eluted, and after some time we obtain two main components, for example, the blue one and the red one, and then you can see that with the elution, with the passage of time, the two components are separated, and you can see in the fourth column the red one sample is separated, and then we separate in the last column, the sixth one, we separate the last component. So this is the example of the absorption chromatography. Type of absorption chromatography. The first important one is thin layer chromatography. Thin layer chromatography is based on the separation of mixture using a thin layer of stationary phase. The second class is the column chromatography. This technique is the one in which the mixture travels down a column when the individual components are absorbed by the stationary phase. And the third one is gas solid chromatography. It is used for the solute which have less solubility in the stationary phase. So these are the three main important types of absorption chromatography. Now, applications of absorption chromatography. Chromatography is widely used. It is used for the separation of amino acids. It is also used for the separation and identification or carbohydrates in unknown samples, and it is also used for the separation and identification of proteins and peptides. It is also used for the separation and identification of natural and synthetic drugs. The second important type is partition chromatography. In this case, solute are separated based on their partition between a liquid mobile phase and a liquid stationary phase coated on a solid support. The liquid surface is immobilized by a stationary phase, which results in making its a stationary phase. Mobile phase flows from the stationary phase and components are separated. The separation depends on different partition coefficients of the solutes. Now there are some types of partition chromatography. The first one is liquid-liquid chromatography. In this case, this is a technique where a sheet of blotting paper is used instead of absorption column. And the second class is the type is gas liquid chromatography. This technique is the one in which the separation of the mixture is done by an inert gas along the tube. Examples of this partition chromatography is paper chromatography. You can see this examples, this figure in which a filter paper is used. You draw a line on the filter paper, you put an ink or plant dye, and then you can see when you put it in the solvent tank, you can see that the different with the passage of time, the different colors will be, the different colors or the different components will be separated. This is quite common for the sake of amino acid separation. The third important example is the ion exchange chromatography. The technique in which ions are separated on the basis of their tendency to displace a counter ion adsorbed on the stationary phase. So it is somehow an adsorption but based on the ionic. We have different type of stationary phases. One is an anionic stationary phase, which is used for cation separation. And then we have cationic stationary phases, which are used for anion separation in the biological system. Separation in the ion exchange chromatography depends on the charge on the molecules or the stationary phase, hydration and solubility. You can see in this case we have two type of ion exchangers systems, and you can see the S represent the samples in both cases. So if you have the stationary phase with the positive charge, so you can separate the samples with the S, and they will, while the positive will elute really easily. Similar is the case of cationic exchanger, where cation is exchanged, and you can see that they are interacting. So the interaction is based here on the ion, which are ion exchange system. Application of ion exchange chromatography. This type of chromatography is also very important. So it is commonly used for the separation of proteins. In the laboratories, especially in the biochemical or the biochemistry laboratory, biotechnology and bioscience laboratories, this technique is widely used for the separation of amino acid, peptides and proteins. This ion exchange chromatography has widely used for the clinical applications. So, for example, the dialysis at the kidney, separation of creatine kinase isoenzyme from humans, and similarly the other enzymes too, and the separation of lipids, carbohydrates, and other metabolites, which are usually polar in the blood. And the third application is industrial application. It is widely used in different type of industries, especially the pharmaceutical industries, where the new drugs are either separated and purified. It is also used in industry for water purification system. Its fourth application is in the food sector. It is used for the separation and purification of different food components, which are obtained from the market or the agricultures, and it is also used for the isolation of different metabolites. The fourth class, which is very important in this case, is the size exclusion chromatography. In some cases, we mentioned first, second, or third. So you are not supposed to be confused with the numbering. Separation in this case is a result of trapping of the molecule in the pores of the packing material. The separation occurs due to the size or weight in some cases. This chromatography was invented in 1955 by Lethe and Ruthven from at the UK. They use this for this technique is used for the analysis of large molecules such as protein polymer. The technique is similar to column chromatography, but the separation concept is different. So you are not supposed to be confused with the column chromatography. It's the same column chromatography, but the stationary phase are different. You can see in this figure, we have a column and we have stationary phases. And then these blue, green, and red are the different size particles. And you can see in the third row that they are separated based on their interactions on the basis of their size. Okay, so the bigger molecules, the first one, they will separate. There are a lot of application of this chromatography. The first is one is in the biochemical applications. In the biochemical laboratories, it is used for the separation of proteins and enzymes. This is very common. It is used in the polymer science laboratories or in the polymer science industries. In this case, it is used to fractionate polymer, different type of polymers. The most important example of this kind of chromatography is gel permeation chromatography.